It's a great outdoors. It's fresh air.
Look, Tommy, we know you're getting a hard time off Lizzie, but there's really no need to take it out on us.
Doesn't it make you proud to be Scottish?
It's shite being Scottish! We're the lowest of low! We're the scum of the fucking earth! The most wretched, miserable, servile, pathetic trash that was ever shattered to civilization! Some people hate the English, I don't! They're just wankers!
And the Oscar goes to...
Christian for his great Scottish accent and also editing those clips together.
Friends, welcome back to the Brave New World show. I'm Academy Award winner Christian, and today I'm talking about a movie I love, Trainspotting.
If you're unfamiliar with the film, Trainspotting came out in 1996 and is based on the novel of the same name. It follows a group of heroin addicts living in Scotland. It quickly became a cult classic for kind of identifying this young unrest in the 90s, and it was also a huge breakout film for Ian McGregor.
One of the things I love most about the movie Trainspotting is the costumes. It feels so authentic and cool, and there's an element of like basically every outfit in there that you can draw inspiration from, you can pull something from it. Thanks to the work of costume designer Rachel Fleming, basically every fit in Trainspotting feels at least organic, and there's a lot of material to kind of look at and be inspired by. And I would point out that something that's pretty interesting about Trainspotting, especially being like a fashion influence, is that the premise of the film is about these characters that kind of exist outside of capitalism. Look at the intro monologue that Ewan gives in the beginning, where he's talking about basically the fallacy of existing in that system.
Choose leisure wear and matching luggage. Choose a three-piece suite on hire purchase and a range of fucking fabrics.
But despite the fact that these are basically anti-capitalist drug addicts, they have a style that is really cool and desirable. I guess that is kind of something that fashion does a lot. It will look at the cultures outside of the wealthy or the middle class, and it will pull from those in order to be inspired. You know, we're always taking from the lower class to make rich people look cool.
Derelict! It is the fashion, a way of life inspired by the very homeless.
So without further ado, let's look at some of the scenes and analyze some of the best fits in the movie. Let's begin with one of these early scenes in the film. Ewan McGregor is playing protagonist Mark Retton, and as you can see immediately, this fit kind of exemplifies a lot of the cool things that are done with the costumes, especially his character. He's wearing these really interesting circular sunglasses, and he has this sweatshirt on that I thought at first was like a real tree pattern, but it's so cool, not only because it's kind of cropped and boxy in the right way, but the way that it's distressed feels very truthful and very vintage. I love the distressing on the collar and the sleeves. Distressed garments that aren't jeans can sometimes be very challenging to pull off. It can look contrived or silly. I guess a good example of this right now would be the bare knuckles sweater that just came out. That was really cool, the way that it's basically shaped in a very similar way to this sweatshirt. And I guess moving forward, if you are interested in kind of buying a vintage sweatshirt and distressing it yourself, maybe look at these clips, maybe be very aware of everything else you're wearing so that it comes off as deliberate and, you know, a little more cool, opposed to looking kind of like a poser or looking just like a garbage sweatshirt. I think you really, honestly, you need to be confident. If you want to wear a top that's distressed, you need to be confident in that statement, because otherwise it could just go very south quickly. One obvious way to define this aesthetic, I guess, would be to call it heroin chic. And that doesn't necessarily have to just define the fact that Ewan's character is very thin. His silhouettes of his clothing are also very skinny and slim. Here's the important takeaway if you're actually looking to draw inspiration from this film. That silhouette or style isn't necessarily what's in vogue. It's certainly not what I've been talking about in my channels, but what's cool is how it feels very authentic and truthful. that is kind of the key element of style. It's not about doing what's the most trendiest, it's about kind of finding an authentic and comfortable aesthetic. In this scene, Mark Retton is wearing this t-shirt that almost is like a crop top, and I think that that's so interesting. It's something that I feel like I would never pull off, but in this scene and for this character, it feels natural and truthful, and it does look cool. Let me make the point that obviously Ewan's character isn't actually interested in fashion. He's probably not interested in a lot more than scoring heroin, but he is truthful to himself, I guess. That's kind of the element. And the beginning monologue points out the fallacy of caring about material things. So, you know, I want to bring that to the forefront as I'm talking about these outfits. It's like, this character doesn't care about clothing. This is probably just some garbage he picked up at a Salvation Army. But it's all about him kind of putting it together and feeling very truthful and kind of existing in these clothes that make them so interesting. Sick Boy to the far right in this clip is also a very stylish character. To begin, I like his bleached hair. I like what he's wearing with his outfit. He's got that blazer on with the lapel collar folded up. He's got the docks and the striped pants. Remind you of anything? And the sunglasses. It feels, once again, super authentic. It's not like the blazer is worn in some kind of preppy way. It kind of feels like these pieces exist in a real wardrobe and are being put together in a normal way for like this hike that they're going on. It's the difference between putting your outfit together as like a costume and putting it together as something that feels natural and normal. And I know I keep saying that a million times in this video, saying authentic, natural, or like truthful, but there's just something about, you could see these characters, you could see the way that the costumes are put together, and it doesn't feel like a costume. It feels like cool clothing that isn't so cared for, that isn't so precious.
Diane was right. The world is changing. Music is changing. Drugs are changing. Even men and women are changing. 1,000 years from now, there'll be no guys and no girls, just wankers. Sounds great to me.
I've got that lust for life. A lust for life. Guys, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel. Comment down below what you think of Trainspotting and the costumes. Do you think there's an even better movie out there? Because I would argue this has the best outfits of any movie. If you think so, comment below, follow me on Instagram, and stay tuned. I know I say I try to post every week. It turns out it's sometimes twice a week, but sometimes life gets in the way, you know? And say yes to life. That's what they say in the movie. So say yes to life.